In one of my prior videos, I've stated that not all garage doors are created equal. And I believe that concept applies to almost anything in life. In fact, in one of my original videos, I focused on the importance of replacing the right garage door cables to the right garage door. For example, like on this Martin garage door. Ugh, Martin. So I wanted to return back to this theme with part 2 and highlight the importance of getting the right garage door cables because trust me, party people, not all garage door cables are created equal either, especially for Wayne Dalton garage doors. Truth is, there are a number of problems that could come from bad garage door cables. From imbalances to unlevel garage doors, like you see here in this portion of the video. Garage door cables are vital to the use of the garage door. But when cables become tangled or break from their loops, a number of major problems can occur. Thus, it's important to recognize and understand that getting the right garage door cable will help with the overall use of your garage door. Here's a perfect example. These garage door cables were purchased from a local hardware store by a customer. As you can tell, their loops are big. No, wait. Let's be honest. They're grotesquely big. Here's the thing. Loops, or hoops, depending on which part of the hemisphere y'all are from, play a major role to a garage door. And when it comes to installing or applying garage door cables, these loops mean everything.
So that's why I don't recommend that you go to places like Home Depot or Lowe's or any of these retail places because they don't have the right garage door cables. These loops are very, very important to pay attention to. And because I think cables are specific to each garage door, it's important to know your door, to know what type of door you have, what model you have at least. And at that point, you can determine on the type of cables that you need. At any rate, buying cables like these from a local hardware store will not help you in the long run. In fact, it can cause more problems than they're worth.
Now, each garage door cable will have a specific bottom bracket hook for the garage door cable loops. And if you're not paying attention to the size of that hook, you could have the wrong garage door cables. There are specific sizes to each loop, as you can tell right here. And that's because this particular door resembles a Millennium, CHI, and Unique garage door brand. Clearly, these loops were designed for this bracket. And yes, we'll be talking about Wayne Dalton cables, so stay with me, party people. In fact, if you've made it this far in the video, please like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell so that way you can get the latest videos on garage door tech and tips. Now, some cables will simply snap off from the bottom door bracket. This can happen due to corrosion or certain wear and tear to the actual cable, as you see here in this portion of the video. A worn garage door cable will also show specific signs of fraying and is a good indication that you need to replace it before it's too late. So here we have an example of the right garage door cables. These loops are the proper size. The gauge or thickness of the cables are standard. As you can see here, simply snap off the old cable and hook on the new one. It looks easy, but that's only because there's access to the bottom end bracket. And that's not always the case. These cables easily connect to standard 4-inch door drums. In fact, it's important to remember the garage door drums go on the tube a specific way. If you're inside the garage, the red drum is on the left side and the black drum is on the right side. Here's a pro tip. Never take off the bottom door brackets when there is tension to the garage door springs. You must release the tension to the garage door springs before even taking off the cables to the bottom bracket. you will hurt yourself if you try to take off the bottom door brackets with tension to the springs. Being able to replace the cables will require certain ingenuity and the right tools. So if you are not confident about replacing the cables, please, party people, don't risk it. No one will judge you. So if you're not handy and you do not have the proper tools, I highly recommend that you hire a professional. Now, garage door cables should come with a tag or label. These Wayne Dalton cables are tagged according to what size door you have. A 7-foot high garage door will require a 101 Wayne Dalton cable, and a 8-foot high garage door will require a 116 Wayne Dalton garage door cable. Notice I keep repeating the name Wayne Dalton. That's because their door cables are proprietary to their garage doors, specifically the 8000 series, model 9100, and model 9605. So here I'm converting and replacing Wayne Dalton TorqueMaster garage door cables on a 9100 model door. These cable loops are much smaller in diameter. This is on purpose because the hooks to the Wayne Dalton bottom door bracket is also smaller in diameter. Bigger or wider loops or hoops, if you want to get scientific, will not work on this door. I do not recommend even using a medium-sized loop such as the one featured earlier in this video. Sure, you can replace the bottom door brackets and have them work with medium cables, but on a Wayne Dalton 9100 model door, that's not possible. You can imagine what could happen if you installed cables with larger hoops to this door. Trust me, party people, I've done it, and they don't work. The point is, your garage door needs the right garage door cable. So paying close attention to this vital and key aspect to your garage door, if and when your cables need to be replaced, will save you time, money, and stress. That's going to be it for this one, party people. Please, if you found this video informative and insightful, like, consider subscribing, and smash that notification button to get the latest garage door tech reviews to help you make a better buying decision. Thanks for watching. Y'all stay safe.